Hey, Lori Gemini Tarot here. I'm here to give you your reading for Leo for March 2021. Yes. Alrighty then, let's get into this. If you are new here, hello, my name is Lori Gemini Tarot and I am a tarot reader. How this works is that I will be throwing down three readings. I will be using three different decks. So if the first reading doesn't resonate, usually the second and the third one will. Please note that these are general collective readings. Make sure you check your sun, moon, and ascending sign. Make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you know when I'm going live and when I'm dropping content. Make sure to comment down below if the reading resonates with you, you like the decks, you like what the hell is coming out of my mouth, and if you'd like to book a personal tarot reading, in the description box below is a link to my Instagram channel. You can check out my pricing and DM me to book a tarot reading. Now, when I did a pre-shuffle, I felt like there was very big positive changes that were coming for you. Felt like it was a transformation and you're just blooming, you're transcending. So that is also what I heard. So let's go ahead and get into this. And one. And just a heads up, if you do hear some background noises, I do have windows open, my boyfriend is working, and I have pets here, so you may hear some noises. So 1, 2, 3, let's get to this. Now let's go ahead and get into your reading for Leo for March 2021. I do have the Six of Swords here, so you are moving on from bigger and better things, or to bigger and better things, I should say. Now we've got the Sun card, your energy, with the Leo card here. See? Good times are rolling. Starting to feel like your old self again. I do have the Wheel of Fortune here, which is amazing balls. Let's go ahead and get into this further. I do have the Seven of Cups. Okay. I have the Nine of Wands. Let me throw down three more cards for you, Leo. The Three of Wands. The Fool card, Sagittarius energy. One more card for Leo. And I have the Judgment card, which is Scorpio. Excuse me. So the bottom of the deck, the overall energy I do have for Leo for March 2021, it is the Tower card, okay, which is Scorpio energy. Now, everybody freaks out with a Tower card. They always expect the worst, and depending on the placements of the cards, it can be, depending on the placement of the cards. However, I don't get any of that energy with this reading, all right? I don't get any lies. I don't get any deceptions. I don't get any negativity. I get only positivity. So the Tower card represents an unexpected surprise, unexpected news. It could be a major fluke, all right? And a fluke is basically a big mistake, all right? So this could be a job offer you thought you did not get, but you got. This could be a relationship that happens to fall into your lap. Maybe you were expecting that you could never, ever, ever get pregnant, and then one day you did. But whatever the case may be, big surprises and awards are coming your way. And it's because you've done the work. It's because you've learned to love and value yourself. You've learned healthy boundaries. You know how to say no. And you've been just treating yourself, just taking extra care of yourself. And because you've been aligned with the universe, you are being rewarded in the most unexpected way. So let's get into this. So starting off, I do have the Six of Swords here. This is you moving on from very hard times. This could have been getting out of a rocky relationship or maybe a rough patch through a relationship. This could be getting out of a shitty job or just overall just shit sandwich that we call life, right? This has been presented to you and you've gotten away unscathed, right? Your heart may be bruised, your ego may be bruised, 444, but overall, you're happy that you got out when you did. And with the Sun card, this is your card, your energy. Things are looking up Millhouse, right? You are feeling like your old self again. It just feels like almost nothing has changed, like since this cloud, this overpass, just these, you know, since 2020, now 2020 is behind you. Now you're very optimistic and you feel childlike. You want to reconnect with friends, family. You want to celebrate. You want to go on adventures. The Wheel of Fortune here, the next 3 to 6 months, you're going to be receiving a lot of good luck. And look at this. See, this is you, Leo. Look at that. That's you walking over this bridge. So all this, like, 2020 and just everything that was bad, it's all water under the bridge right now. You're going over and it's now the sunny side of life. So in the next 3 to 6 months, you're going to be rewarded with good luck, love, abundance, prosperity, and it's going to be sprinkled throughout the next 3 to 6 months, okay? Now during this time, in the next 3 to 6 months, you may be feeling very confused, all right? You may be drinking a little bit too much, maybe smoking a little bit too much weed, maybe just over excessively looking at pornography or, you know, just sexy time. It feels like, or somebody may be going out and doing drag racing. Somebody's got a race, right? Somebody's got a race. Okay. It feels like somebody is trying to catch some sort of high, get that thrill. It feels like, you know what, 2020, I've been stuck in a house. I want some thrills, okay? But just be careful to not go over excessive. I'm seeing like somebody going to Vegas or going into a big city and they're getting like, and they're getting alcohol poisoning. So be careful of that, Leo, okay? The Nine of Wands, there's victory here. Victory is always gonna be at your side. I know you're always overlooking your shoulder, expecting the worst case scenario or expecting the other shoe to drop, but know that you're a winner, baby, and you're ready to jump into this new path. The Three Wands, you're moving on to bigger and better things. I feel like you've dodged a bullet in some way, or you've got out of a very risky situation. It could be, I'm glad that I got out the job that I did, because once I did, then that company fell apart. Or I'm glad I got out of that relationship afterwards. You know, things unraveled and I found out a whole bunch of truth about this person, and I'm glad I'm no longer associated with this clown. It feels like you are moving on to bigger and better things. I'm also seeing somebody traveling for vacation. This could be for a long distance relationship as well. The Full card, Sagittarius energy. You have luck, loyalty, friendship is always by your side. You're ready for a new adventure. I'm seeing somebody also adopting a pet. I'm also seeing somebody just finally getting out of the house and getting laid. I also heard that as well. Somebody's ready to go on some sort of road trip, some sort of backpacking trip, cross country trip. They want to see the world. There's nothing wrong with taking a solo or independent trip. I'm just seeing like courage and courageous. I'm seeing adventurous. Somebody really has a lot of balls or cojones to really put themselves out there. And Judgment card, Scorpio energy. This is a rebirth. This is an awakening. For some, this is a spiritual awakening. I'm seeing reunions, family reunions, connecting with old friends, colleagues, reconnecting and having a good time. It feels like your name is also going to be cleared, is also what I got. So, that was your first reading. So, if that resonated, make sure you comment down below, Leo. Let me go ahead and use two more decks just for you. So this is going to be for Leo. This is going to be for Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising for March 2021. For Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising. Alrighty then. You could be dealing with an Aries. You could have Aries in your chart, Sun, Moon, Rising. You could be dealing with parental, father figure issues. You could be dealing with just a nasty boss. It feels like you're focusing on restructuring your life and finding new goals and ambition and just trying to regain control of your life. Okay. So let's go ahead and get into this, Leo. So there's a good time for you to work with others. There may be ideas and they may provide some constructive criticism. So don't get butt hurt. If they provide you with feedback, don't take things so personal, and you don't always need a compliment sandwich. And what I mean by that is that you don't need somebody to kiss your ass and then give you constructive criticism and then kiss your ass again. You don't need that. You're a grown-ass adult. Take the constructive criticism. They're trying to help you, all right? Don't take it as there's something wrong with you or your ego being bruised, okay? Don't get defensive. This information is actually helping you to thrive and to improve. Get outside and get out of the house and be around nature. You know, it's a really good time for you to take a vacation, take a holiday, take a trip. You just need to rebuild your foundation. You need to be grounded again. You could also be dealing with earth signs. You could also have that in your chart, Sun, Moon, Rising. You also need to take some sort of break and just come back and reevaluate the situation. You're thinking it's the worst case, worst scenario when it honestly isn't. You're freaking out over nothing, Leo. Just stop being dramatic. I just feel like you're being over dramatic over the situation. You're meant to teach people in some way. It does not always have to be children, but you have a gift to teach. So you need to figure out what your skills are and what you're able to teach, where you're able to share your knowledge, and how you can make that apply and make it happen. And your spirit guides are supporting you in this matter. If you keep on seeing 1111, that's mean your wishes are going to be coming true. They're going to be fulfilled. You're going to be connecting with your twin flame or your soulmate, your true love. Make a wish because it will come true. And focus on positive thoughts because what you project to the universe will come back to you. So you start projecting negative things into the universe, it will project back to you. So when you start getting into that downward spiral where you start just start tearing yourself apart, stop yourself immediately and start shooting off 3 positive things about yourself or 3 positive things that you want to manifest. You're definitely having your spiritual awakening, Leo, and you're becoming aligned with the universe. Follow your intuition. And your spirit guides want you to know that there's something else better on its way to you. And even though what you think you had was it, just expect it to be amazing. Just, you know, patience and trust is the key. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and give you your final reading. So if you've been with me from day one, you would know that this last deck has been with me since the end of time. So let's go ahead and get into this. This is going to be for Leo. All right. So Leo, believe what you see, face reality, or live in fucking la la land. Choose bravely. Shit is going down at your job. Reevaluate, change your perspective, or fucking quit. Fucking apologize. Seriously, just do it. Some good shit's about to happen. Don't let your issues fuck it up. you're giving away your power. You're a badass. Act like it. And finally, it's not everyone else's fault. It's yours. You're a grown-ass adult. Stop blaming others for your shit. So, Leo, that was your reading for March 2021. If that resonated with you, make sure to comment down below. Hit the like button. Subscribe to this channel. Thank you for watching. Please be safe. Wash your damn hands. And nanu nanu.